Marjorie Taylor Greene is suing to stop the challenge that has been filed against her using the 14th Amendment to try to bar her from being on the ballot this year. And of course, if it's successful, would bar her from ever being on a ballot ever again here in the United States. So she's a little scared of this, doesn't want it to happen. So she's filed this lawsuit to try to prevent the challenge from even taking place. And before I get into her legal rationale for allegedly saying this challenge is unconstitutional, let's think about this for a minute. You're given an opportunity with the challenge itself to prove that you didn't do what the challengers say you did, which is, of course, support the insurrection. So you have every legal opportunity to go there and defend yourself and present evidence showing that their claims are total BS. So you do have the legal avenue in front of you without filing your own lawsuit to stop it before it starts to prove that they're wrong, but you don't want to do that. And to me, right off the bat, that tells us that this challenge is heading in the right direction. Nobody wants to get sued. Nobody wants to face legal problems, I can promise you that. But if you know you did nothing wrong, and you've got all the money like Marjorie Taylor Greene does, let's not forget, she is a multimillionaire, you can afford good lawyers, this isn't something you really need to worry about. It's an annoying thing, yeah, but you know you're going to get out of it and it's not going to amount to anything. You're not even letting that happen. You're trying to kneecap justice before we can even get that far. That tells me you are very scared about what could happen with this challenge. As I mentioned, let's get to her legal rationale. Greene's lawsuit asks a judge to declare that the law that the voters are using to challenge her eligibility is itself unconstitutional and to prohibit state officials from enforcing it. You're trying to say that literally the 14th Amendment of the Constitution is itself unconstitutional. You know, maybe I gotta take back what I said just a moment ago, where I mentioned that you are a multimillionaire and you can afford the best lawyers in the country, because if that's your lawyer's legal argument, then you did not pay for the best. You know, you probably went to somebody in a strip mall somewhere and asked them, if this is the argument they came up with, telling us that the Constitution is unconstitutional, best of luck with that defense. The lawsuit also alleges that the challenge statute directly usurps Congress's constitutional ability to judge whether a member is qualified. Again, you're challenging the constitutionality of the Constitution. I don't know who your lawyers are, but I'm going to go ahead and guess that they're not good. As somebody who has, for almost two decades now, literally worked with the best lawyers in this country, I have sat down and interviewed many of the lawyers that have been inducted into the National Trial Lawyer Hall of Fame. And the folks that you've got representing you, Marjorie, I can guarantee you they're never going to make it there. They're not going to become household names. They're not going to be the big guys on the news handling the big cases, because these are really stupid legal arguments that even somebody that hasn't gone to law school would be able to dismantle in court. Again, if you've got nothing to worry about, just let the challenge play out, go defend yourself in court, and that'll be the end of it. You win. But this particular challenge, as I've mentioned in the past, I'm optimistic about this one. I don't know why it is, but I am. The words that she used, you know, this is our 1776 moment. I don't know. That's pretty charged language, and I think that the group filing the challenge against her, Free Speech for People, they've got a hell of a case. And we just heard what Marjorie Taylor Greene's defense is, and I don't think she has a legal leg to stand on, and she should be very worried right now. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.